to talk to you about how having positive self-talk has been proven to lead to more success in life and better physical health. So we can start by talking about the mental health effects of thinking positively. This is Dr. Barbara Fredrickson. She's a psychology researcher at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, and she conducted a study where she took her subjects and divided them into five separate groups. The first two groups were shown clips of positive emotions like joy and contentment. The third group was the control group, and the fourth and fifth group were shown clips of negative emotions like fear and anger. And after all the clips were shown to the five groups, they were all given the same scenario or situation where they had to write about how they would escape or get out of the situation. And after analyzing her results, she found that groups 1 and 2 that were shown more positive emotions like joy and contentment had significantly more to say about their plan to escape the scenario than 4 and 5 who had the least to say. So this just kind of shows that negative thinking really narrows your mind and doesn't allow you to think outside the box or plan strategically about how to escape any scenario. And next, we'll look at this situation. Many psychologists have used this to explain how negative emotions narrow your thoughts. So you're walking along this path and you see a dangerous animal like a tiger. Your initial feeling is fear, which is a negative emotion that consumes you. And all of a sudden, everything else around you becomes irrelevant. And although fear is important for you to escape this tiger, this is just an example of how all of a sudden you just focus on running away. You don't notice the trees, the dirt, or anything else. So it really just shows how everything else becomes irrelevant and negative thinking just like completely consumes you and all you can focus on is that one negative emotion. So another example of how negative thinking can impact your mental health is Dr. Seligman from Harvard University ran a study where he observed 500 incoming freshmen at the University of Pennsylvania. He worked alongside the dean of admissions there who pointed out to him that the admissions office could predict the students' success in their freshman year by looking at their GPA and their test scores. After observing the students, Dr. Seligman found out that it was the students' individual explanatory style or the way they were able to work through situations and problem solve that determined if they would do better or worse than this predicted level of success. So his final conclusion was that college entrance exams measure talent, while explanatory style tells you who gives up. So this is kind of similar to how hard work is more important than talent because it can teach you how to overcome adversities in life. So now that we've talked about the mental health benefits of positive thinking, we can discuss the physical health benefits. So a research fellow also from Harvard named Eric Kim constructed a study where he observed a group of women over 8 years, and these women were ranked based on a series of questions and interviews as either more positive or more negative. And after observing them for 8 years, he assessed them physically and mentally, and he came to these conclusions. So he found that positive women had 30% lower risk of dying from any disease, 38% lower risk of dying from heart disease, and 52% lower risk of dying from any infection. He also found that negative women had 60% higher risk of dying from cancer, and a 39% higher risk of dying from a stroke. So this just shows that negative thinking and the stress brought along with that really takes a toll on your body. It starts to deteriorate your body a lot faster than just time alone can. So now that you're hopefully convinced on the effects of positive versus negative thinking on your body, we can talk about how to keep your mind on a more optimistic track. So the first thing you should do is just to start small. Don't try to conquer your whole life at once, but pick maybe a class or a sport that you find yourself in, especially negative, just try to make sure all your thoughts are more positive in that area, and eventually you can work for your entire life. Next, you want to make sure you maintain positivity throughout your day by just stopping to make sure you're not thinking negatively about anything in particular, and if you are, just try to reverse that. Think of it in a more positive way, and eventually this will just become a habit to you, and you won't even realize you're doing it. And next, the most important to me, I think, is to surround yourself with positive people. Because negative people only want to bring you down with them, and when you're having a bad day or you're feeling low about yourself, a positive person can really come and shed light on the situation, and they can bring you up when you're feeling down. So it's important to have positive people in your life. And lastly, you want to make sure you live physically healthy life. lives. If you're eating right and exercising, you're